I'm Mary Ann Hansen. I'm an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension. And we're out here on this crisp fall day on October 16th, 2017, looking at root problems on trees. And this maple tree that I'm standing in front of has a problem called stem girdling roots. Normally, the root systems of trees will grow out horizontally away from the trunk, and they will produce a kind of a flare at the base of the trunk where the root joins the trunk. Sometimes roots don't grow in those normal directions. They grow in an abnormal direction, and this is often caused by plants being pot bound in the nursery. So if you buy a tree or shrub that has been growing in a small pot or a pot that's too small for it for too long, then the roots reach the outer edge of the root ball and they begin to grow in a circle. And that circular growth pattern can continue once you transplant that shrub or tree into the landscape. On this particular tree that we're looking at, we can see these stem girdling roots above ground. So we can see them right at the base of the trunk. We can see roots growing right next to the trunk, kind of in a circular pattern. That is not normal. A lot of times those stem girdling roots are actually below ground, and so you can't even see them on the soil surface, and you may not know what's wrong with your tree. But another indication of stem girdling roots is if you have a trunk that looks like a telephone pole going into the ground, so it just looks like it goes straight into the ground. Even if it's only on one side that it looks that way, then it's got an abnormally growing root on that side. So a normal, healthy tree should have flare on all sides of the trunk. So if you have an abnormally growing root and it grows close to the trunk, it grows in diameter as the trunk grows in diameter, and eventually that root compresses the growth on the trunk. And what happens then is it's compressing the tissues in the tree that transport carbohydrates from the leaves to the roots, keeping the roots alive. And it also inhibits the transport of water from the roots to the leaves, keeping the tree alive. So those functions are impaired, and eventually the tree shows symptoms of that stress. And you'll see it in sort of non-diagnostic symptoms of general yellowing or leaf scorch, stunting of the leaves or the growth overall. And frequently you'll see dieback of the branches as we do in the canopy of this tree. It's fall, but it hasn't lost its leaves because of fall leaf coloration. And senescence, it's lost its leaves because of stem girdling roots. We often don't think about the roots when we look up at the canopy of the tree. The main thing that you can do about this is to prevent it in the first place. There's not a lot you can do about it once it's happened and once you notice it. Usually it's been happening for a period of years. So the best thing to do is to avoid buying either trees or shrubs that are obviously pot bound. You pull them out of the pot and they've got roots all the way out to the edge of the root ball and they're growing around in a circle. You don't want to buy that kind of plant. It's been growing in that pot too long. Another thing to avoid is to plant your tree or shrub too deeply. Actually, this has been shown to cause roots to grow in abnormal directions. So you want to make sure, especially with trees, you want to be able to see that flare root at the soil line. Then you know you've planted it to the correct depth. And sometimes you're buying these plants that have already been planted too deeply at the nursery. So make sure you see that flare at the soil line all the way around the tree. That indicates that you don't have any abnormally growing roots. Once you've planted a tree or it's been in the landscape for a long time and you notice that it may have a stem girdling root, sometimes it's possible to sever those roots and to have the tree keep growing. Usually it's too late for that. But if it's recognized pretty soon after the tree is planted, you can even excavate the root collar, that area around the base of the trunk, and try to cut any roots that appear to be growing in a circular pattern. But basically, the best thing to do is to avoid this problem in the first place. And this problem of stem girdling roots is very, very common in the landscape. It's a very common cause of tree decline. So be careful with what the root system looks like on the plants that you buy, and be careful not to plant them too deeply.